Hello everybody, welcome back to justlaravel.com. Here in this video, I am going to show you how to implement search functionality in Laravel. Actually, there is also a post here. There is also a working demo that is working pretty well. And there is also a project on GitHub, the same thing. But I decided to make a video on it. So that would be also helpful with all these resources. So this is pretty simple. We'll just use some basic form and use the database queries to search and show in the results view. So let's get started. Actually, this is the demo. This is the form we use. If we search for something like Bob or something, if there are any users related to Bob, it will show here. Yeah, actually, there's only one person named Bob. So we'll search for something like B, so that will get many users. You can see this, all the names or emails which have the letter B will show up here. So this is how the basic example works. So now I'll create a new application show you all this. So let's get started. First, I will fire up my terminal, create a new project. So I'm going to create a new project named search example video. So this will create as a new project here. So let's wait for this to finish. So we can see this application got created here. So we'll just go into the folder CD, we'll created search example video. So now we'll clear and we'll go here. If we just run this application using this PHP artisan serve command, like you see that it's a localhost development server started in 8000. You can see this Laravel so that you can confirm that our application got created. So now let me open this project in some text editor. I will open here Sublime text editor. This is the application here in Sublime. So first open this welcome.blade and we'll keep some form there instead of this all this. Actually, we need to keep this form here. For that, I will remove all this styles and all, and I will just modify and keep it just and I'll keep just a basic form here. So basically, I have created a form here, created all this stuff from this welcome.blade, and just included some bootstrap CSS and JS, and created one basic form here. This is the form with one input field, that is to search, and a button which is attached to input group. So this is only one field. So and its method is post. We have to use this CSRF field when using post method, and the URL is slash search. So now we'll save this and done this here. You can see this the search field appeared here. So we can do something like that, but nothing will happen because this route is not found. So what we'll do is so basically we got the form here. And also I made this action to call this slash search here. So I'll go to the roots file and create a root for it. So the get root is already defined, which I've changed the blade pair, and here I will write a post root for slash search. And one thing here, we can also write in a controller, like some controller name we can give, main controller, and its function method name. But we are going to use only one method here. So I don't want to create a controller here. I will just create a function here. Here in this application, we need only one function and nothing else. So I'll create a function here and write everything related to the logic here itself. So I'll just now try to get the input which is entered in the form there. So query equal to input get, we have given a name of Q there. So in this here we are given a name of Q, so we need to retrieve that, and let's check whether that is coming or not. DD, we'll just DD and check. Actually, we need to also use this import, use this input here. So that will be in eliminate support facets. So I'll just import it. Now, so now we can use this input. So now let's try and see. We'll just refresh. So now I'll enter some random text and I'll press this search icon. So it shows this ERE, that is this DD is working here, so that we can confirm that text is coming here. So now what we'll do is we'll search in the database actually we have to configure our database details here. Here in this env file, database name, username will be a root, there will be no password, and database name will be, the table name is just Laravel demos, so I'll use that. Actually I have already some users in that table, and so these are the users, these are the names and users, so we can use them. So let's go to our application here. So we can use this app/user here, so that we can use that model here. So now we'll check whether that the queue is empty or not. If queue not equal to empty, we'll go further and check the database. So or else we'll return that we'll return something. First let us keep that no query, no data found, something like that. Later we'll modify this. So if this is not equal to empty, then we'll go and check in the database, query the user table, user where name, we'll check for name and email. Well, name like, so we can use this like operator to match the content in the database. Use this percentage, this should be like this one, the query to be matched dot, and again this percentage. So what this do is if anything in the database with in this name column, if anything matches with this, that means like queue, so that we can find those details. Or where we can also check for email also, so we can do this as or where email, the same thing we'll do for email here. Instead of name we'll type email, we'll use this get operation, so we'll get the results in this user field. So if now we'll check if count of users are greater than 0, this count of this user. So if we have any users, if any results found, we'll just we need to show the results in the view. So what we'll do is we'll just return it to the view, return view, what is it, welcome, so we'll return it with the details found here, with details, this this with and this details is a magic function. So we can use this with details and use this results variable here, this variable which contains results user like this. Actually what this does with detail, what this magic function does, this is pretty equal to this thing like with details. Actually we'll send like this with details comma dollar $USER. This also pretty, this thing and this magic function are pretty equal, so we can call this this user's data in the view using this details variable. Similarly we can also do the same with this magic functions. So I'm using that thing here, so with details, and also we need to send with the query, so what the user have entered, dollar dollar cube, so that is the query here. If there are no users also, we'll send some message, something if there are no users, return view welcome with message. Instead of these details, I'll send some message that would be statically typed, something like no details found, try again later, no users found, something like that. So now we'll go to the view here and add something, add some table or something to show the results. So we'll go here, after this form we'll write some if condition, if is set details, Oh, and we'll also end if here. That means only if there are details here, we only find something some results in this user variable, only then this the part in this if block will show, or else it won't show anything. So if we set details, if there are details, so what we need to do is just write a show a paragraph the search results. Actually, you can see here the search results for your query br. So we'll write this text here. Yeah, actually the search results for your query are this dollar query is coming from here. This with query is also magic function. So when we have written like this, so we can use that query variable here. So first thing is this. We have shown this the search results for a query, and we have sample user details here. So we'll just write a h1 here, h1 or h2. So after this, we will write a table here with two fields. So we'll create a table using Bootstrap. So can we use this table script class? So we can also give this as a table. So in this table, what we'll do is we'll have this table. So for the table head, name and email fields, and in the t body for loop, each of the results from the details for each dollar details as dollar user. So what we'll do is here, so we'll loop all the results and show each result. We'll end for each here. So td, this would be dollar user nans to name, and this would be dollar user of email, and we need to wrap this in this curly double curly braces. This is the, we are using this Laravel default uses this blade template. This is the blade syntax. So we need to only show this too, and we'll need to close this. And so now we'll run the application and check the details here. So in this US table, we enter something like EA, and I will search. So you can see this all the results for the word EA. If you will directly search with this email, we can see only one result found. You can see only that email came, and you can also see the search results for your query are. And if we have entered nothing and given. And if something which is not there we have entered, it should show. It is not showing anything because we have not shown this this here with the message here. So we also need to show this message somewhere here. Before ending, we'll write some else if here at the rate of. Else if, what we'll do is that message. Oh, we'll find if there is a message. Oh, we want to show that message. That is, we will show it in a, and we'll show it like this. Check and now if we check again and see it's an empty query, we should see that message here. No users found, you can see, or else something if you like type like this, which is not in the database, you can also see that no users found. And if you enter something which is in the database, you can see that results. So that is how basically this example is here in this example. Oh, and this is a post for it. I've created it long back. There is also a demo and the project that is done at that time in the GitHub. So just this is a video demonstration of this. In this, someone prefers this video format rather than this blog post format. Oh, I made this so I created this video. You can also get this project repository here, that is GitHub. This is my username Avinash and search example Laravel. I will also provide all these details and links in the description, so please check the description. And that's it for the video. If you like these videos, Please subscribe to the channel, share it with your friends, put a like, comment. Stay tuned for more videos from justlaravel.com. See you in the next video. Bye bye.